read stories about this place where it doesn't come back and their devices are completely broken. So I've heard that this place doesn't even, or they have to say, like, hey, your shit's not, we're not liable for your shit breaking if it
Yeah,
doesn't work.
I think some lady from the Pfister Hotel had to call AppleCare because
Oh,
she was
seriously?
having, well,
Her phone. Because
her
her
phone
fucking phone got
from the
busted.
Sports Strangest episode. You were
Yeah.
not in attendance for that section of it, but it happened, Drea. And yeah, it's apparently in that one hotel, this one time they messed with this lady's battery on her phone, and she fixed it, but it was weird though.
Close
Oh, it happened.
call.
It
It was a
happens all the
close
time.
call.
It's a telltale sign if your battery suddenly drains and it's like, well, I had a full charge. Well, guess what? There's something there sapping that energy.
Yeah,
Don't know
that's
what to
it.
tell you.
Makes sense.
Something similar happened to the on Cursed: The Blair Witch, where they had one of those like full spectrum cameras that records on like the ultraviolet level or something, and they recorded in there, and then that camera kind of pooped out, and they had to come out. And then, but then to get it to work again, they called this guy Pastor James, and he said,
"Break the curse! Break the curse!"
All
Oh,
right.
damn it.
I'm breaking the curse of having to hear about this anymore. Now, it's a fascinating story, but as you can see, it's easy to pull it in this area. Now it's about a cave. It's like they have to have something to latch onto in this modern day because the story won't go away. Very, very cool poltergeist story. You guys have any final thoughts on the actual Bell Witch?
Well, I definitely do because I mean, I was so stoked when you brought this up because this is one of my favorite stories. And one thing that I know about this is that apparently this Bell Witch is not just, she doesn't work alone. She is part of a group, a coven, if you will, but they don't call it that. But there's like a family of spirits that she's a part of, and they have other names. Like the other people have names. They have much cooler names. Their names like Black Dog, Mathematics, Sipography, and Jerusalem. And Black Dog's supposed to be like the leader of it. And then there's Kate, who is,
Kate.
yeah, we got
Sounds
Black
like
Dog,
a
Mathematics,
hip hop group.
and Kate. Yeah, I
It's
mean, dude, if they dropped an album, I would be on
sound like
that.
members of Odd Future. It
Yeah.
sounds like Slender Man's friends, and like Kate's like the rake of the group, where it's like, wait, what?
Oh,
I hear
yeah,
that
we've got
one
like
red Maskey and the rake.
Kill John Bell featuring Slender Man. That'd be great. Hey,
Yeah.
that I want to commission. If AC Dollar Sign could do a song, a rap about these guys, I'd much rather the focus be on this group of weirdos instead of us.
I just can't stop thinking about how funny it would be if the Girl Scout group and the Girl Scout troop and Zach Baggins and all of them and the A&E crew all showed up at the same time there to do their shit, and they're just like dude, just this convergence of fucking madness.
Yeah,
I
I have.
also really like that the Girl Scout troop and Girl Scout group is so easily confused. Like,
Yeah,
Girl
I
Scout.
know. I know. I slipped
Really
up on
good.
that one. I'm
Good.
sorry, Girl
No,
Scouts.
it
Sorry
sounds
to
even
our.
better. That's a good rap name.
And they got, Zip Baggins has his John Bell descendant. Curse Colin the Bell Witch have their descendant. And then, like, if one of the little Girl Scouts was like, I'm descended from Kate Batts. And like, oh, no. And
Yeah,
then.
like you're not in there anymore.
It
Please
sounds
leave.
like that place
No.
is so popular that, I'm almost scared to go there. Just, I don't want to run into any Zach Bagginses or any random Girl Scout troops, you know?
Oh, I think that I actually do want to. I think we should all organize a trip and definitely go there.
Well, if I see those Girl Scouts there, I'm bringing my pastor buddy with him because he's going to tell them.
Break the curse! Break the curse!
All
This is
right.
my new favorite clip. Thank
Let's get
you.
out of here. So, Drea, look, we need a poll for this week. What do you think the poll should be for this Bell Witch episode?
Well, okay, the one question that's on my mind this whole time is her. She's all erratic and everything. She's kind of crazy. I'm thinking, why was this the witch such of a bitch? How about that? Is it okay to use the word bitch now still? Is that a no-no word? Well, but, I mean, I think she was being a bitch.
You'll get bleeped out.
Yeah, whoops.
Well, we can say it, though, so, yeah.
Can y'all scream like a...
Can y'all scream like a... Sorry, I'm done with that. Okay.
Let's go, everyone just go to UnbelieversPodcast.com and go answer this week's poll. Why was the Belle Witch such a bitch? That sounds good. And now we are going to take some of our winners from previous poll results and we're going to play the game. But we're getting a little burnt out on playing Why Do I Know This? So we're going to play a new game.
Welcome to 25,000 Props Pyramid. And now, here's your host, Russ Ryan.
Hello, thank you everyone, and welcome to the all-new Unbelievers Podcast game, the 25,000 Props Pyramid. 10 points up for grabs today, as always. And let's first meet our first contender, Wiener Von Braun. Right here. Okay. Well, wow, Wiener, congratulations. You are the first challenger on the 25,000 Props Pyramid. How are you feeling today?
Ready for action.
Excellent. And now, our returning champion, even though it's our first time playing, it is Raymond.
Yeah.
Hey, welcome. Now we have a seat over here, and so this is the first time we're playing the 25,000 Props Pyramid, and you will each be paired up with one of our celebrity partners we have for you today, and you will have they will be giving you clues to a word, and you have to guess that word, and there are 10 of them you need to guess. But enough of that. Who are we pairing you up with today? Well, let's welcome to the program Drea Mora and Rob Oakey. Oh, yes, here they come.
Hey, what's happening?
They're blowing kisses to the crowd.
I love you. I love you.
Rob
guys.
Is bowing. He's bowing. Oh.
Thank you. Not worthy.
Wow, it is. Is an honor to have you two here as partners. Now, you will each be paired with one of our contestants today. Now, since Raymond is our returning champion, even though it's the first time we're playing, Raymond, who would you like to be your partner to give you clues today? Would you like the lovely Drea Mora or the lovely Rob Oakey?
Russ, I just want to thank you for the opportunity to come on this show. Thank our God, J. Allen Hynek, for being here. Fabulous. sorry, I just wanted to play that up. I want to pick, let's go with Drea today.
Okay, so our team is going to be Raymond and Drea and Wiener and Rob. Okay, so I'm going to, like I said before, you're going to have 1 minute, and your celebrity partner will give you clues to a word that you need to say. Now, your partners cannot say any part of the actual word you need to say. If they do say that, you will hear this sound.
No! 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 No!
Okay? That means you have already lost that point. There's no going back. Now, either the celebrity partner can choose to skip, or you as the contestant can choose to skip, and when the time runs out, you will hear this sound. Okay. So, we are now going to go, and there are four categories today. And let's take a look at the big board over here, and I will introduce the categories. Today's categories are classic cryptids, eerie ETs, podcast people, and remarkable relics. Now, as the challenger, I'm going to let you go first, the team of Wiener and Rob. So, Wiener, what category would you like to choose?
I'm an old man, so I think I could go for classic cryptids.
Classic cryptids. Okay. Now, and also I didn't mention this, but when you get one correct, and it's time to move on, you will hear this. Okay, but remember, if Rob says something wrong, you're going to hear,
no!
Or maybe,
you are an idiot.
Okay, or something like that. Possibly.
You suck, you jackass.
All right. Now, here we go with our first category for the team of Wiener and Rob, classic cryptids. 1 minute, and your time starts now.
Okay. He lives in West Virginia. He doesn't like bridges. He predicts bad stuff that's going to happen. He can fly.
Lizard man?
He can fly.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Okay. Let's see. He has scales. He eats cars. He has a tail.
Lizard man.
All right. This one lives in a body of water. The most famous body of water dweller.
Loch Ness monster.
There you go. This one is South American. South American.
Chupacabra.
There you go. This one, a big guy, lives in the woods. Hairy.
Bigfoot.
There you go. All right. This one, northeastern cryptid, has horns. He's a bad guy, the opposite of God. All right, skip that one. Skip that one.
Jersey Devil.
Oh, there you go. This one is a cousin of the big guy who lives in the woods. He's a lighter color. Lives in the snow area.
Yeti.
There you go.
Yeti, abominable snowman.
This one is part man. Oh, I fucked up.
No!
Okay, this one lives in a wall. Very smart ass. One of the wonders of the world.
Jeff. Jeff the mongoose.
10 seconds.
And then this one is can be pronounced many ways from Louisiana. Not the loop garoop. It's the
And time. All right, congratulations. Hey, we have to
good
end
job,
this out.
Rob. What?
Very
that's
good
tough.
Job.
It's kind of tough.
Very good job. I'm glad.
All right. Well, great job. The team of Wiener and Rob. You got 8 correct out of that. Very
woo!
Good.
Hell yeah, Wiener.
A time limit.
You're my boy.
That's very good. The only two you got wrong is because Rob said big and Rob said man or dog.
I said man. I think I said man.
Man.
I said half
let
man.
All put together, he said big man.
Big man.
Wiener, let me see if I could help you. Hairy guy. He lives in the woods. He could also sometimes called a Sasquatch. He's the most popular cryptid ever.
Tim Good.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, Raymond Andrea, it is your time up. And now you have the choice of eerie ETs, podcast people, or remarkable relics. What would you choose, Raymond?
Eerie ETs.
Yes.
The category of eerie ETs is just different either alien races or specific aliens that we know that have names. And now, Drea, I will be putting the 2 minutes on the clock, and you will be starting now.
Okay, this is your standard go-to default race.
Grace. Okay.
Yes. Okay. This one, a group, also kind of a race, talked about by the Native Americans. that come from
Skinwalker.